Okay, you ready?
I'm always ready.
Okay.
Go for it. Hi, and welcome back to Alberta Camping. Today we are at Paddy Flats, and we arrived yesterday.
Yep.
Feels like we've been here longer than that.
Well, we've been camping for, 11 days now? So we're 11 days camping.
Well, June 29th. It's a Saturday.
Okay.
Think?
12 days?
Don't know. We've been out for a while. And we're determined that we're doing a whole month of this. We went straight to Beaver Flat and had a great time there. We had a site right on the water. So all you heard was the river. And we had quite a few storms, though. It was quite chilly. A lot of storms. But we had one night that was absolutely beautiful. And John got these amazing pictures of the Milky Way. We saw Jupiter. It was awesome. It was a late night trying to capture those pictures. It was like 2 in the morning.
12:30. It was 12:30 by the time we got the best picture.
We were up later than that. Like 1:30.
Yeah, it took a while, but it was worth it. But it's been the only night so far we've had clear enough skies to take nighttime pictures.
We haven't had like the big huge storms that I expected, like the hail and everything.
We had one day we had a little bit of hail.
It was tiny little hail.
But not much.
Calgary got worse. They got the brunt of the storm. We were out here in Kananaskis country. We didn't get it. We've had lots of rain though, and chilly days, not very much sun. So I'm really happy to see the sun shining today and not having to wear winter clothing. It's been chilly.
First time on this trip, actually, I've opened the vents in the trailer. They haven't been open all for the whole trip.
Yeah.
So it's warm enough now in there to open up the vents. I haven't turned the fans on yet.
Can we turn the fans on? We're dry camping.
Yep. During the day, you can have the fans going.
Oh. We don't need it. I notice here, though, it's windy at Paddy Flats.
Well, today and yesterday.
Well, the only time we've been here is today and yesterday.
Yeah.
It's quite windy. And I notice a lot more bugs. A lot of mosquitoes and flies and bees. We hardly had any down it. Maybe it was because of the weather.
Probably.
And now it's gotten nice.
Now the bugs are coming out.
Yeah, they're bugging me.
So what did you see this morning, Heather?
Oh my goodness. So let me tell the story, because I like telling stories. So I get up, it was about 8:30, and the chairs are around the fire pit from last night. So I just sat down in my chair and I had my phone, because here at Paddy's Flat you can get cell service. And I'm just sitting there and I heard some footsteps on gravel, but I didn't think much of it. I thought maybe it was John inside making some noise because I had heard him moving around. Then all of a sudden, the camper door, the trailer opens, and John goes, "Heather!" He points in behind the trailer. So I look up, and what do I see? I see the biggest moose ever on the other side of the trailer, right on the road. I was like, what did my face do?
It dropped.
Luckily, because a lot of times when those type of things happen, I don't have a camera or my phone handy. Well, luckily, I had my phone in my hand. And what did I get?
Picture of a moose.
A really good picture of a moose. I was so happy because I never see wildlife. And I've seen a nice big moose kind of looked at me, kind of stopped and posed for a picture. That was pretty awesome. But I also saw the cutest baby bighorn sheep on the road, on the highway, out to Little Elbow. Oh, I love them both. They usually run away. They see me coming, and John sees wildlife all the time. Me, no, not so much. So the moose's name is Beavis. We name all the wildlife. Yeah. I love him. He was massive. He was the same height as your truck.
Yep.
He was really big. Can you insert a picture right here?
Yeah.
Of Beavis?
Yeah.
Beavis. I love him.
What about the baby sheep?
What about him?
You didn't name him.
I just called him Baby, remember? Because he was so cute. He was the littlest baby sheep I've ever seen.
Actually, I think it was a mountain goat.
Okay, it was a mountain goat. But no matter. And maybe it was, actually. Now that I think about it.
Yeah, it was a goat.
It was a mountain goat. And he was so cute. Oh my goodness. I've never seen one so little in all my life. This is him. That's Baby. I love him. Why do you laugh at me? So here we are. Patty's flat. We're going to be here till at least Sunday. And then we don't know where we're going from there.
Might just stay here. Might go somewhere else.
Don't know. But we do know we drove out to Little Elbow. We weren't thrilled about that campground. We'll do a review about it. But it just doesn't feel like me. You know?
Well, the sites are smaller. They're closer together. A lot of the sites are on mounds, so as soon as you step out of your door, you got a 3-foot drop. So
yeah.
If you're up late and you're having a little bit of after-hour cocktails, it might be a little hazardous to your health.
Yeah, you'd have to have cocktails during happy hour.
Might explain why the helicopters go up there way a lot. I've noticed.
But I do want to go out to Forget-Me-Not Pond and wander around there. So there are advantages of being out there. It's beautiful. The drive out is beautiful. I don't know, a couple big hills though. If you don't like driving your trailer on big hills, big mountains. Yeah, the one is really steep and long.
Yeah.
But it's beautiful out there. Like, I would definitely go out for a hike and go to Forget-Me-Not Pond. I think there's lots of hiking out there.
Yeah. There's lots of hiking here too, so anywhere in the Elbow Valley's got lots of hiking.
Yeah, Beaver Flat. That's where we stayed and it was beautiful. I loved it there. And I would camp on almost any site there. And now we're at Patty's Flat, which we love. We've been here before. And we'll do a whole review on that one. And then, what else is around? Oh, Gooseberry looks pretty run down.
Gooseberry's looking run down.
Yeah. I was surprised.
Even though it got renovated a couple years ago and got power put in for probably 2/3 of the sites there.
Yeah.
It is still a little bit run down.
Well, and like the sites, it used to be like those sites that were right along the river. Well, the river is pretty much non-existent now.
Yeah.
And they've got like construction fencing up. So on your site is the construction fencing by the river. So they're really quite ugly.
And potholes like crazy.
It's really bad out here. I have never seen it this bad before. Especially Patty's is really bad. Like, you have to go super slow. I'm talking 2-3 kilometers an hour through some of the roads here. Because the potholes are, there's so many and they're so big. Like, you make sure that you batten down the hatches really well inside your trailer before you drive into these campgrounds. Because the potholes are really massive. It's really bad. We actually talked to the host about it. And they're like, yeah, we've talked about it. We've asked about it. And the only way, really, is for people to phone in, write in complaints about it. So get on it. I know I'm going to be. Because it's bad. Like, and it doesn't just need to be graded. It needs gravel.
Yep.
Yeah. But other than that, you know, the majority of the camp, it just depends what you like in a campground. So we don't care if it's rustic with no power, and we just like this.
Yeah.
Forested and
lots of trees, lots of, you can be private if you want, or you can have company.
Yeah, and these sites are big enough. Like, some of the sites are massive. You could put 2 or 3 trailers on them.
Yeah.
This one is big enough for 2, for sure.
At Little Elbow, we noticed there was a ton of double sites. People, like, they're attached to each other, so that's great if you got a family and you got friends coming, you're on, taking up two sites, but if you're just out camping on your own, well, you're attached to your neighbor a little bit too closely.
Yeah, like you could, here, pass me a beer.
Pretty much.
And they could throw one to you from their campfire. Yeah, that's a little too close. I don't mind having people around me. I just don't want to have them listening in to every conversation I have. So what's the plans coming up?
Today?
Yeah. What are we going to do today?
I don't know. Kind of a relaxation day again.
Yeah, but we got a lot to do tomorrow. To go into town tomorrow.
So we'll probably relax today. Go into town tomorrow.
Gotta get groceries, have a shower. Hence the hat. I didn't want to show you my hair right now. It's not greasy, it's just not pretty.
Gotta replenish supplies.
Yep. Just mostly need food. Have a shower.
Yep.
Miscellaneous stuff. Go visit the kid. We're gonna bring one with us. So on our way back out, we're picking up Ethan, who's 20, going on 21. He's gonna come out for the weekend and visit with us. So that'll be nice. Haven't seen him in a while. That'll be good. I look forward to seeing him. Maybe play some games. I like playing games. John, how much do you like playing games? On a scale of 1 to 10.
1. Maybe 2. Depends on the game.
It makes me sad.
Not really a big card player at all.
I love cards. Love playing cards.
Boring.
So, I'm out camping with John. Just John and I. I like playing games. He doesn't like playing games. So what have I done? I've read 10 books since July, or June 28th. 10 books. I'm on my 11th.
I read 2.
So that could get a little boring after a while. I need you to not learn games, just play them with me.
Occasionally I do. Not very often, but
we have like ladder ball and Yahtzee.
That's true.
Would you play those?
It's usually more fun with more people.
I'm fun.
It's true, but if I beat you too often, you get upset.
That's such a lie. I let you win so that you keep playing. There's a strategy behind it.
Right.
Yeah. I like playing things like card games. Uno, you need more people.
Right.
Crib, we can play that together.
Yeah, not a crib fan.
Backgammon? I have backgammon.
Mm. Haven't played that since I was a kid.
Sequence. I brought out Sequence.
That's his cards.
That's fun. Mm. It's a strategy game. More than a card game. Looks like I need to learn a whole pile of solitaire games.
That's true. You have your phone.
Well, I've been playing games on my phone because I don't have anybody to play games with.
You have a phone.
There's not a whole lot of interaction happening. You have to entertain me.
Really?
Yeah.
So I come camping and go relax. But apparently I have to be an entertainment system while mm-hmm. I'm at it.
Yeah, it's true. Mm-hmm. I get bored easily.
Maybe you shouldn't camp.
That's rude. I like camping.
But you said it was boring.
Well, it's boring if I don't have any entertainment. You just want to sit here.
Yeah.
You can sit for hours without a book, without your phone, and just sit.
Yeah.
I can't do that. There's no way. I have to have something to do. I was doing puzzle games, puzzle book. I had my reading books. I had my phone with little games on them.
So, this is a classic case of undiagnosed ADHD.
No, I just like to keep my mind engaged. Mm-hmm. I'm not ADHD.
What's the other one?
What do you mean?
You can't sit still.
Hyperactive?
Maybe that's it.
Well, that's part of the H in ADHD.
There you go.
Oh, well. It doesn't matter what diagnosis I have. I just like to be doing something. I like exploring. So going for walks and on little hikes. I like to see and new things. Take pictures.
I can go get a pail of water and you can wash the trailer. That should keep you busy. That'll take at least a couple hours.
You're just a barrel of laughs, aren't you?
Well, you want to keep busy.
I know what I'll do. I'll get all the firewood chopped for tonight.
Except Heather's not allowed to chop firewood.
I can.
Against the law.
John's law?
No. Family law.
Family law. Yeah, the boys won't let me either.
No.
I pick up the axe and everybody comes running and takes it out of my hands.
Guess you chopped a finger off once.
Grew back. It grew back, seriously. I grow things back.
I know, but you chopped it off and we haven't let you do it since.
That's true. I'm just in shock. It did seriously grow back. There's no scar. I didn't have feeling in the tip of my finger for 8 months, but...
Mm-hmm.
I didn't even get stitches. Maybe that's what causes scars.
Maybe.
Maybe it's the stitches.
Maybe.
I just stuck it back together and wrapped it. Polysporin. Washed it. Polysporin. Stuck it back together. And drank some rye. Which is a blood thinner. It was probably not smart that I did that.
No. But.
It healed.
That's why she can't use the axe anymore. We got the tarp up.
You got the tarp up?
That's what you're hearing.
Oh, okay, yeah. Well, you just never know. We've had so many storms. And I want to sit out at the fire. I don't want to be stuck inside the trailer. Speaking of the trailer, one of these days we need to give them a tour. I like our trailer.
Well, I thought you were going to give them a tour today.
Well, let's do it today.
So Heather's going to give you a tour of the trailer now.
I like our trailer. It is kind of homey.
Yep.
We've put up some signage. What would you call them? I guess they're decorations.
Ambiance.
Yep. The tsunami warning one is funny because it's right on the bathroom door. So that's funny. I like that. Yep. We've decorated a little bit, but not a whole lot. But it's comfy. I like it. We don't spend a whole lot of time in there. Because we like to be outside.
Well, Heather's bored. Because nobody's entertaining her.
Ethan will entertain me this weekend. He'll want to play card games. He'll want to play ladder ball. We have badminton rackets. Do we have their croquet here?
Couldn't tell you.
Croquet in the forest might be kind of funny. Maybe not. I hear motorcycles. That's one thing about being here at Patty's Flat. We're on the upper level, upper loop. And then it goes down B, C, D, and E, closer and closer to the river. And these are really awesome, big, huge sites. So we like this. But we are closer to the highway. Being at Beaver Flats, we're right on the river, so we just hold... The roar of the water all the time, it drowned out all sounds. So it was pretty quiet. Now I'm hearing. I think he's coming this way. I don't think he's on the highway.
He was.
Is he in our loop?
Maybe.
No. That's a loud motorcycle.
Well, he's probably using it going out of the exit.
Motorcycles always that loud?
Mostly. A lot of them.
Huh. Yep. He's gone. He came up from a different loop, I think.
Yep.
Jeez, I wouldn't want to drive a motorcycle through this campground with the potholes.
Swerve around them.
I don't even think some of them you can.
No, there is.
That's crazy talk. Anyway, should we give a tour?
Sure. Now Heather will take you on a tour of our camper. Mm-hmm. Hope you enjoy.
I love my trailer. We've been talking a lot about the different campgrounds in and around the Kananaskis area, and today I wanted to show you our trailer and all the things that we've learned over having this trailer for the last couple of years. Now, we bought a Rockwood, it's an ultra light, and it is the model number is 2702WS. And the reason we bought this one is because of storage and because of sleeping arrangements. So welcome to our trailer. First thing, as soon as you walk into the door on the right, is the bedroom, the master, I would call it the master bedroom. It has a ton of storage. We have a full closet with hanging capability there above the bed. That's where like all our shorts and pants and hoodies and stuff all get stored. There's also storage underneath the bed, so it lifts up. So we put things like sleeping bags, things that we don't use very often, down there. Also, I love that on either side of the bed, there's charging, and there's a charging center here for your phones and such like. But I also love reading, and so to have bedside tables is super important to me. This section here, our closet area, there's not a lot of room here, but I love that there's so much storage here for hanging clothes and towels and bedding. This is part of the slide system. So this actually will come in when we're all the slides are in. It comes right up against the bed. So we have to make sure this area is clear. That's another part of it. So we have blankets and towels and clothes. So it's a really, actually, and the bed is comfortable. There's Serta mattresses. We also put a memory foam on top of it though. Let's see if I can actually show you. So there's a memory foam that we put on top of it to make it super, super comfy. And actually this bed is almost more comfortable than the bed we have at home. There is hookups here to be able to put a TV here, but it's not a big room. So we haven't bothered mounting a TV here. But there's lots of natural light in here. There's also the fan above the bed if it gets super, super hot. And there's also these fancy things, falling styrofoam, for air conditioning if we ever have power and it's super hot and we need air conditioning. I think we've used it maybe once or twice. Now the doors, I'll show you these. So the doors here are sliding doors on either side, so we can close them if somebody is in there at night or having a nap during the day. You can still use the rest of the trailer. Mm-hmm. What's really important about these doors is that when you are traveling, be sure to hook these up. We made the mistake once of not hooking it, and it ended up that the door came off the track, and it's almost impossible. We managed, but it was almost impossible to get it back on the track without taking everything completely apart. There's storage right here at the door. Not much, but we put our cleaning supplies down there. And our control center for all our water, the awnings, the slides, everything is right here, easy touch, right at the front of the trailer. And it was also, thermostat is also right here at the door. Now, the thing that I really miss and would really love somehow is to have some sort of coat, closet, or hooks right at the door. And because the closet is right at the back, you have to travel all the way through. So that's the only thing I really miss here. We bought these really great rugs at Costco, so we don't track any dirt or mud into the trailer. We also, right here is our TV and radio. The TV is great. It pulls out, and I'm too dainty and too delicate with it. I should just pull, and turns so that you can watch it from anywhere in the trailer. This also comes off, and you can attach it to the side of the trailer outside, which is kind of a neat feature. Of course, you need power for all of this stuff. Lots of storage above, our bear sprays right at the door, car keys, wallets, flashlights, lights, all the kind of technical things, fire starter, flashlights. They're all here, bug spray. So anything that we need easy accessible for outside is right here. So this whole section here, the couch and the dinette, is also a slide. It comes in pretty much right to here, so you do have a little bit of storage while you're traveling on the floor. And you can sneak past when it's in if you need to get to the fridge while you're traveling. The couch comes out into a bed, so it comes out to about here. We've never used it. We've never had a reason to. We try to use all the other spaces before we do the couch because it would make it difficult in the night. Somebody had to get to the bathroom. We noticed that there was no tables, or side tables for the couch. So if you have a drink or something, it makes it really kind of difficult. So what we did was we just bought one of these, it's actually collapsible ottomans, and we filled it with hats, there's rubber boots, there's mittens, that kind of stuff is all in here. And we can use it as an ottoman or a footstool, but we can also put drinks on it if we're sitting here watching the news. This, it's beautiful, the size, because it fits right underneath the closet slide. So that's a good place to store it when we are traveling on the road. But it just lives here until we need it. You'll notice that there's a ton of storage on the slides, which I really loved when we were looking for a trailer. I wanted storage. Because what I found with a lot of places is that we didn't have enough storage. And we came from a motorhome which had a basement and everything, and it was like a huge amount of storage. So I put all the kitchen dishes and stuff, things that I'm going to use all the time, where it was easy for me to get at. Reaching over the dinette is difficult for me because I'm short, but these, because it's the couch, I can get at really easily. There's a ton of lighting in here. As you can see, there's all these push button lights. There's reading lights. This goes from the bedroom as well. There's the dinette light. We've got the overhead lights. The stove light, the light for the sink. There's a ton of lighting options. We are dry camping the majority of time, so we try not to use the lights. Here at the dinette, there's storage underneath. This one is a drawer that I just keep all our Ziploc bags and containers, so it's easily accessible for me. This one here, we don't use that often. It goes all the way through. You can also lift up the seat and access things, but it also has access to the outside. So I haven't quite figured out what that storage unit is for yet. Above here, more storage. This is what I call the entertainment section. Hope nothing falls out at me. But puzzle books and books and cards and all that fun stuff. See, told you things were going to fall out at me. So like brochures, camping brochures that we have picked up along the way. Those all go in there. We don't use the dinette very often. That's why I don't really care that things are piled up so much on it. So I pile up some of the books that I want to read. And Robert lives here on our table. We'll have a talk about Robert a little later. I want to talk a little bit about this stuff, though. This is how we transport things in and out of the trailer. For meal prep, everything goes on this tray. I think I got it at Indigo. And it makes things so much easier. So if I'm doing some prep in here or gathering things to take outside, because we cook and wash all our dishes outside, everything goes in here and then out the door. Now, for washing dishes, I fill these, one with bubbly water, one with clear water, and this is the drying mat, and I do it outside on the table. So we just keep it here because we hardly ever eat here unless it's storming, and then we just move things. Now back here, this was a big selling feature for us. I call them my cubbies. They are actually double bed mattresses. They're real mattresses, and they are also electric mattresses that you can plug in and heat, which is kind of a cool option. They also have windows. This one down here, I call it the cubby because it's got a ton of pillows and blankets in there, but the window does open if you need air in there, and this also closes to give privacy if somebody is sleeping in there. So it doesn't get used that often, but I do like kind of feeling like a cocoon, so I'll sleep in there every so often. And we've also put a memory foam on this one as well. It doesn't really fit. It's a queen-size memory foam, so we could cut it down, but what it does is cut down on drafts, because underneath this, trying to lift it with all this stuff on it, is another big storage area that leads to outside. So it could, if it's cold out, it does get a little drafty. So this helps a lot, keeping it nice and warm in there. Now, when we travel, this slide comes all the way in. So this stuff cannot be here. And we have to be really cautious of what we put on these bunks when we're traveling. Right now, the upper bunk, we've just stored like the bags that we brought for our clothes. We have big reclining chairs for outside that are really heavy and kind of cumbersome. But since this bunk doesn't get used very often, it's a perfect place for them to store. So things that are like the wash bins and stuff, I'll put on here. There's also a ladder in here that attaches so you can get to the upper bunk really easily. Okay, the kitchen. I'll start back here and work our way for it. Another big selling feature for me, of course, I said about storage earlier, was that we have a big, huge pantry. Now, this is more of closet space, so things like first aid kit, tools, our coats. We have a Coleman lantern, extra barbecue lighters. That type of stuff goes in here. One thing to remember with these ultralight kind of trailers is that everything is light. So you try to put all the heavy stuff at the bottom. We've noticed these shelves are not really heavy duty. So if you put heavy stuff on it, they're going to start to sag. So heavy stuff at the bottom. So down here, we've put all our drinks, water, pops. All that goes down there because they're heavy. In this cubby here, we have a toaster, and the kettle normally is in there. And any bags, garbage bags, kitchen bags, any of our grocery bags we keep in here because they become very useful for other things. We bought these collapsible totes at Costco, and they are amazing. If you have some that aren't being used, they just collapse down and they're really, really easy to store. But what we found is that we could take this whole thing home and fill it with, you know, new dry products. So this is like just food, chips, crackers, spices and such like. This one has our pots and pans in it. And we actually haven't used the pots and pans probably for a year. I don't know if we should even bother having them anymore. And then the miscellaneous items. So right now it's kind of full, but on the most part, when we're traveling, it's pretty empty. What we notice, though, is there's at night, when you come in here to get a snack, and you don't want to be turning all the lights on, that it's really hard to see things. So we just went and bought one of these push lights to light up the pantry, and we just put it on the door. So it's simple addition to a cheap dollar store type thing. So the refrigerator is a decent size. We have to be really careful about the temperature. There is temperature gauge here. I find when it's on the coldest, it kind of ruins your vegetables. So it doesn't need to be there. Only maximum would be the medium. It gets really super cold. But it's a good size. We can put a lot of stuff in there. Moving over to the microwave. We don't use it. So we store our dish towels and dishcloths in there. If we ever needed it, then we just take those out. But we never use the microwave. We never use a stovetop anymore. We used to, and it's got the splash guard and it folds up. And then we discovered outside cooking and had decided that the stove was useless to us. Same goes with the oven. We put cutting boards in there. I'm sure we could store more in there, but right now it's just the cutting boards. Now we have some drawers here. Oh, as you see, that's kind of our bar. The drawers here are just for cutlery and more kitchen gadgets, and then our tin foil and oven mitts. The only thing I miss is not having the cleaning supplies right here, but since we do all of our washing of our dishes and such like outside, it's okay that it's by the door. Another great trick, I'll show you this. It looks like I have a sink full of dirty dishes, which I do. I don't do the dishes after every meal, but what I do, here, I'll take a couple out so I can lift this. What we do is we have a tub that we put right in the sink because we don't want to leave the dirty dishes outside for bugs and animals, of course. So we just leave it here, and when we finish a meal, we stack everything in here, and then I have all the dirty dishes in one tub to take out. It fits right into my black tubs. I can take them outside and get going on my dishwashing. Above here is more storage. We use this mainly for just our cups, our coffee. It opens on the other side too, so the big spatulas for barbecuing and such like are over there so that it's easily accessible from outside. You'll notice that we use a lot of bins for it just makes life easier for transporting things back and forth. And when we're traveling on the road, nothing's getting jostled around. Here's another one of our bins. That one's just full of shoes right now. Another lovely feature is this bathroom. The bathroom is really, really big. And this was important to me because I'm the only female in a family of males. Two young men and a husband. And getting changed is a difficulty in a tiny little bathroom. And I don't really want to do it out where everybody else is standing. So this was a big, huge selling feature for me. The only thing that it's really lacking is storage in the bathroom. Now, I've kept this open right now to show you how much light comes through the skylight. We don't use the shower, hardly ever. I think it's been used two or three times. So we use it. We just put a laundry basket in the tub, and that's where all our dirty clothes go. So when we go to pack up, we're going to go home and have showers and do laundry,
I just have to grab the laundry basket and be done. And it doesn't clutter up any space out there. We also have one of these mats right here in the bathroom that we got at Costco, because this is another lovely feature that you can enter the bathroom from outside without coming through the main trailer. So that was a selling feature for me, because you could just sneak in, go to the bathroom, and sneak out again. At night, I just lock it so that no bears come in, because I know they like to come visit me. We also attached these hooks, just the command hooks, because there was no place to hang a towel. And since we don't really shower here much, we use this also for wet jackets. So if we're wearing a raincoat and it's been storming rain, we can throw that there. Comes with the medicine cabinet. We just found little nooks and crannies to put all our personal goods. We store all our stuff in little travel bags, and then we just put it on top of the medicine cabinet. The one last thing I want to show you, and we just discovered this at Mac, was it's a collapsible garbage bin, but we use it for our recycling. We found that prior to this that we would just have a bag going, and it was always in the way, and we don't want to leave it outside. So this has been great, because once it's full, then we just bound it up and put it in the bed of the truck, ready to go home and recycle. One last thing that I failed to mention earlier was that you'll see here that there's these little grooves. Underneath the bed there, we have stored, it's an extension countertop. It comes out to about here, and it's not, I wouldn't say particularly strong. So you wouldn't want to put anything heavy on it. What it is it hooks in there, and then it has one leg here. I would alter it, actually. I would get two legs with hinges so that it was more stable. But we like the freedom of all this space, because really the trailer has a ton of space with these slides. And we do most of our cooking and prep and such like outside anyway. So that doesn't really bother me. You'll notice I have dirty dishes, paper plates, paper towels. That's for a reason. That is our fire starter. We use paper plates. Unless we need something hard to cut our food on, the majority of the time we're using paper plates to eat off of, and it becomes our fire starter. You can get fire starter from, you know, we buy it at the dollar store if this fails to work. But paper plates are the way to go. Anyway, thank you so much. I hope if you have any questions about our trailer, please feel free to comment on the video. I love this trailer. I really do. There's very minor drawbacks. We've had lots of little things go wrong with it, but we've managed to deal with those. I think that's kind of the quirks of buying something brand new. So that's our trailer. We really like our trailer. On the outside, I was talking earlier about there's mounts for the TV. I have to say, John has rigged up, if we have power, John has rigged up, it's almost like a drive-in movie. He's got a screen and a projector and the computer with a movie on it, all hooked up. So he would string up the screen between two trees and we would watch a movie. People are amazed.
I wouldn't say amazed.
No, they're like, you can hear them going, look, they're watching a movie. Yeah, they did.
Yeah. Who knew?
They did. So we will do an exterior walkthrough of the trailer, because there's a lot of things you should see about how we've set it up, and solar power and generator use and all that fun stuff. We will do another complete whole video on that, just so that you can see all the tricks that we've come up with and how we cook outside and such like. That's another whole video in itself.
Yep. Next week.
Yeah. Wherever we happen to be. Well, thanks for stopping by at Alberta Camping.
subscribe. I'm waiting for you to say something.
Don't forget to like this video and subscribe for more. Starring Heather.
And my Roots attire.
Yeah.